Hello, everybody! This is Punk Demon Neo, and welcome back to the Banjo-Kazooie playthrough! Last time, we took on Level 6, Gobi's Valley, going from the freezer into the oven after going through Freezeezy Peak, and we were able to successfully complete Gobi's Valley in one run, and in addition, we unlocked our final special move of the game, the Running Shoes. Which is going to be very useful for this episode because it's time to actually revisit an earlier level. What's this earlier level, you may ask? Why, it's Freezeezy Peak. Because this is probably the one instance of backtracking in this game that could truly be considered mandatory if you're going for 100%. So let's not waste any time, let's go into Freezeezy Peak. This episode's gonna be relatively short because this is all we're doing. We're just gonna do this bit of backtracking and that's gonna be the end of it. So hopefully this episode won't take very long to do. Anyway, the first thing we need to do is, well, we need to pay a visit to old Boggy here.
Hello again, buddy. I'm waiting for someone to race me.
We'll race ya, numbutt!
Sorry, you're too big for my sled. I can only race someone smaller.
Someone smaller, you say? Well, I think I know someone who can help us with that department. Someone whose name starts with Mumbo. I think you know where this is going. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, we have to once again become a walrus in order to do this next Jiggy Challenge. And this part of the Jiggy Challenge, you don't have to backtrack to do this one. However, you do have to backtrack to do the Jiggy Challenge immediately following this one, which is why I left Freezeezy Peak when I did. So let's actually go ahead and see if we can actually finish off this level.
Hey, Mr. Walrus, fancy a race? Hop on the sled if you do.
All right, here we go.
Great, now all you need to do is steer your sled through the red slalom gates and beat me to the end. Got it? 3, 2, 1, go!
All right, this isn't too hard. All you have to do is, as Boggy says, you just need to control your sled. And, you know, just go through the gates and you'll do just fine. Boggy here isn't too bad, although he can catch you if you don't watch it. But he's not that difficult. The second Boggy challenge can be a problem if you don't play it properly. Or if you're, if you don't respect his AI, because he does have a bit of a rubber band to his AI, at least in the second challenge. But here, he's not so bad. Come on, baby. Who would have thought you'd ever see this, a walrus and a polar bear on sleds racing each other? You gotta love Banjo-Kazooie. You just gotta love it. And I might be in real danger of losing this thing. Come on, baby. Let's go. Oh yeah, come on. You ain't nothing, Boggy. You ain't nothing. You ain't nothing!
Phew! You're too quick for me, Mr. Walrus. Here's your medal. I reckon I need to race someone my own size.
Yeah, what was that about needing to race somebody smaller? Size don't matter, son. You got something to say? You got something to say? Now, I'm talking smack, but we're not done with him yet. In order to do the next Boggy challenge, we have to actually go back to regular Banjo and Kazooie, and this is the challenge that's going to require the running shoes. So this is why this challenge requires backtracking. So I'm going to do a quick cut, and once I'm back to regular Banjo-Kazooie, I'll see you guys back at Boggy's. Alright, so here we are back as regular Banjo and Kazooie, and I think it's time for a rematch.
Hey buddy, fancy a race against Boggy? Press A to accept or B to chicken out.
I ain't no chicken.
Okay buddy, here's the rules. Run through the red slalom gates and try to beat me to the end.
Let's do it! 3, 2, 1, go!
Okay, grab the running shoes. And here's another tip. Do not immediately go full throttle because Boggy has rubber band AI in this race. The best strategy is to stay just behind him as long as you can and then take the lead at the very end. If you try to go full throttle, full speed through the entire race, he will actually catch up and overtake you. I know because it's actually happened to me. So I'm speaking from experience on that. Luckily, the course doesn't really change all that much. It's just that Boggy is faster and you need the running shoes. Because if you do not have the running shoes, you cannot accomplish this challenge. He'll simply be too quick. So you need the running shoes to have even a chance at keeping up with him. Alright, let's go. Let's go, buddy! Ha ha! I beat you even worse!
Oh, I've lost again. Take my other medal. I'm off to look for my kid's presents.
Sorry, buddy, I took care of that like 3 episodes ago. We know where your priorities are. So yeah, I think I actually beat him even worse. I beat him by a greater distance that time, but again, like I said, he does have rubber band AI. Like the strategy I employed, staying behind him for most of the race and then taking the lead at the end, to me, that's the best way to approach this. And that's gonna do it for Free ZZ Peak. We have finally beaten this level in full. All the jiggies have been collected, and that means another level can be crossed off the to-do list. It's time to leave Free ZZ Peak for good, and it's time to make preparations to enter the next level, which is gonna require a little bit of work. We're gonna have to actually explore a part of Gruntilda's lair that we haven't seen yet, because we're getting really deep into the Witch's Lair now with the last set of levels that we actually have to do. Okay. Now we're still not done with the area outside Free ZZ Peak. We're gonna have to now see if we can claim the Overworld Jiggy that's associated with this level, and this is another Jiggy that's going to require the use of the running shoes. Let's see if we can do this. Oh, shoot! I forgot about that spider web. I won't be able to use that flight pad. Dang it! I got a little ahead of myself on that one. Alright. Let's try this again. So, yes. The first thing you need to do: break open that spider web so you can actually get to the flight pad that appears in that little pit. How could I forget to do that? I was so focused on getting to the running shoes and starting the challenge, I forgot that extra step. Because of course I would forget. Alright, let's try again. And we're gonna get it right this time. Or I could miss the running shoes! Dang it! Okay. Take three. Oh my god! Can I please succeed at this challenge? Why am I failing? I'm not gonna make it again. Why can't I succeed? Got it! Finally, man. This is definitely one of the more frustrating jiggies to try to get in the overworld because of, you know, having to race a clock. Luckily, once you get to the flight pad and you finally take flight, you can actually, you know, get to the jiggy. Man, that one took some work, let me tell ya. And there's really no point to using the flight pad here, except to take out this asshole! Take that, Snowboy. Of all the enemies to put in the overworld, the friggin' snowman. Okay. Now we have a little bit of work to do, because now it's time to unlock the next level in line. But first, we have some things we can still do in this large room. First of all, we can activate another cauldron. You still want to keep an eye out for these guys so you can activate shortcuts through the witch's lair. There's also another Brentilda encounter right over here. The disgusting Gruntilda has rat bagels for breakfast. Yeah, that sounds pretty disgusting. Then she usually has slug stew for dinner. Yuck! And finally, wart bags then finishes with rat sorbet for dessert. How horrid! And sometimes Gruntilda will do this when you talk to her. She'll refill your health. So apparently Gruntilda's diet involves stuff with rats. Alright. We can't do anything with that cauldron for the time being, but we can open another note door. 450 notes! We definitely exceed that total by a wide margin, and now for a new area of the lair. Now, there are upper areas here, but we can't do anything about them. The place we want to go is this tunnel right over here. So let's go ahead and go on through. Now, one thing I definitely have to praise in terms of sound design is how the music changes when you're underwater. In fact, that's one thing I love about the soundtrack of Banjo-Kazooie, is that as you go through different parts of the game, the soundtrack changes, like instruments are added or instruments are taken away, and like the soundtrack to this game, the sound design is just excellent. Like, this is one of my favorite video game soundtracks of all time. Whenever I listen to music from Banjo-Kazooie, I just get filled with an instant feeling of nostalgia. I could listen to it all day. So this room contains the jiggy puzzle for our next level, but we're gonna have to do some platforming if we want to reach it. So let's go and do some platforming, ladies and gentlemen. I mean, that's the whole point of the game. It is a 3D platformer. And I fail on the last jump. That was a nice display of platforming skills, wasn't it? Not. There we go. Alright, this one's gonna require quite a few jiggies. and Gruntilda continues to taunt us. 10 jiggies for that puzzle will unlock Mad Monster Mansion. That should be an interesting level, and that should do it for this room. Well, there is a Mumbo token, might want to grab that. Alright, I think that's about all we can do in this here room, so let's get out of here. No sense in hanging around a place we don't really need to be, am I right? You know I'm right. I don't need to ask that question. Am I right? Of course I'm right. I'm always right, even when I'm wrong. It's like Tony Montana. I always tell the truth, even when I lie. Alright, so this room, I'll go ahead and talk about this room very briefly. This room actually contains the entrance to level 8. Unfortunately, we can't access it right now, and we won't be accessing it for quite a while. But still, thought it would be a good thing to bring up. So we will be coming back to this particular room later on. But for the time being, let's go ahead and grab another Mumbo token, and let's make our exit. And once we get back to dry land... Alrighty then, I think this is a pretty good place to stop. And that is going to do it for this episode of the Banjo-Kazooie playthrough. We have finished off Freezeezy Peak, and we have unlocked level 7, Mad Monster Mansion. If you want to see that level, you're going to have to wait until the next recording. This is Punk Demon Neo signing out for now. If you folks liked what you saw, be sure to like, leave a comment, and tell me what you think. And I'll see all of you in the next episode.